is Al Rulton. Live in London, Ontario. My bike is called Blown Money. Pride and joy, I guess you'd want to call it. Myself and some very talented people helped me make it, which I would like to acknowledge through this interview. Redid it 3 years ago. Looked like they found Connery Brothers for the paint. Absolutely brilliant, brilliant painters. It's always fun getting on it. Attention getter, there's no question about that. The bike itself is built, is based on a Bourget. It's a Bourget style motorcycle. I found a Bourget down in Toronto, which I took some pictures of and so forth. Found a Campbell Metal Specialties here in London and approached him, and together him and me made the frame from scratch on it. Used some of the things I liked that the Bourget had and other things that I wanted on my own. As far as rake and trail, we put the oil in the frame, all the wiring hidden in the frame. It took a year to get the frame done the first time here. After that, I took it to Scott McCallum at DynoFab Custom Cycles. He handmade the tank and the handlebars and just numerous items handmade. Did a wonderful job for me, great to work with. That probably took close to another year, if not a little more, before we had that thing up and running. The bike originally was supposed to be the Candy Apple Red, the color, and it was supposed to have the blower on it. Couldn't afford it the first time. Couple years later, paid off all those debts and bought a few more pieces. Totally redid the bike, and again, that's what I said. I took it to the January show and came in first in builder's class there, which was a real thrill for me. I was happy with that, and the London show also. Those are the only two shows. I didn't do a lot of the trailering all over the place doing shows. It was more just for something to do in the winter time, and met a lot of great people. Well, the motor is an S&S, 107 cubic inch. Again, it's a square motor, what they class as a square motor. It was originally selected to put a blower on it because I always wanted to put a blower on it down the road, and everybody told me that was the strongest motor at the time that for a blower to be put on. I stuck with the 107, drove it around a couple years with just the 107 without the blower, made about 110 horsepower. With the blower on it, we're looking at about 150 horsepower right now. It's very strong. We haven't got it dialed all the way up. I'm sure we could even get more horsepower of it, but I need it to be reliable and rideable all at the same time. Transmission, just a standard 5-speed transmission, low ratio, beefed up for the power. Handles it well, no issues that way. I don't really need a 6-speed. I'm not doing a lot of highway riding with it, so I was quite happy with it. This is a RevTech transmission that's in it right now. And right now it's handling the power no problem, so I have no issues that way. Yeah, the front end is a mean street front end. Also, the headlight is a mean street also. It came as a package. We selected our own length, did our own rake and so forth on it. It's a nice inverted fork front end on it. It was real cutting edge at the time. Yeah, the wheels are RC Comp. Excellent, excellent quality wheels. I would buy them again in a second here. They also, with the matching one-sided pulley where I've got the combination brake and pulley on the one side, kept the other side wide open so you can look at, you can see nothing but rim, which I really, really like. I like the fact that I was able to maintain the belt drive. A lot of people were going to chain at the time, but we really tried hard and we made a belt drive work on the thing. It's a little narrower than a normal Harley one, but so far it's put up with the power, no problem. I haven't any issues with that. So, problem's too strong of a word, but there was always some issue that we had to deal with or something that was unforeseen. And if you budgeted a month's worth of time, it was always 2 months. But to make it right, you didn't have a problem waiting for it. You know, if something had to be machined or something had to be made to make it look better, we certainly did it. We didn't rush the build. It was done, everything was done to the best of my ability and the people that were helping me ability. Without question. So my only tip would be to anybody building a bike would be to make sure you're 100%, if 95% sure on what you want on that motorcycle before you actually order one part. there's nothing worse than putting a part on that you don't like because you've spent all that money and what are you going to do with it then? But what I've seen other people do is they'll get partway through a build, they'll see a part that wasn't originally intended to be on the bike, they'll see it, they'll like it, and then they try to incorporate that part on a bike. And what you end up having is you have two different visions now. You've got a bike that you've started to look this particular way, and halfway through the build, you're bolting on other parts. And I've seen it where the whole bike doesn't look like it, in my opinion, the whole bike doesn't look like it flows, like it's a natural looking bike. It looks like you've just bolted on parts for the sake of bolting on parts. And if you're really sure ahead of time, do your research. With the internet, that just saved me. I mean, I learned so much on not only the parts I wanted, but how those parts would interact with other parts, because you're using 100 different manufacturers and 100 different types of bolts and so on and so forth, and they all gotta mesh together, and some parts just don't mesh together. And it's a lot easier to find out before you're trying to fit it together that's not going to work for you versus as you're sitting there scratching your head and trying to figure out what you're going to do now.